Hello friends, in this video we will learn the working of NAND latch. Let us begin. So let us understand a NAND latch. As you can see, the NAND latch is again a combination of two NAND gates which are cross coupled. And again, to start with this NAND latch, first of all, let us review the NAND gate truth table. With AB, we have four possible combinations, and for every combination, I have written the respective output. In fact, NAND gate is exactly inverse of AND gate. In AND gate, output is 1 only if both the inputs were 1. Here exactly reverse is happening. When both the inputs are at 1, output is 0, and for rest of the combinations, you are getting output as 1. Because in AND gate, when one of the input is fixed to 0, output is always 0. In NAND gate, when one of the input is 0, output is always 1. So, as you can see, again, with this partition, in above two combinations, A is equal to 0, and in lower two combinations, A equal to 1. And for every combination of A, I'll try to get Y in terms of B. So, let's see. When A is equal to 0, B 0 makes it 1, B equal to 1, again, output is making it as 1, meaning that output is independent of B, Y equal to 1. This is called as a disable condition of NAND gate. When one of the input is fixed to 0, output is always 1, irrespective what you have applied the status of other input. Whereas in A equal to 1 combination, let's see, when B equal to 0, Y is 1, when B equal to 1, Y is 0, meaning that it is exactly inverse of B. Therefore, Y equal to B bar. So, here when one of the input is fixed to 1, it acts as NOT gate for the other input. So, let us verify the property again. The property of NAND gate is that when one of the input is fixed to 0, it is getting disabled and therefore output is 1 irrespective what you have applied on the other input. Whereas, when one of the input is fixed to 1, it acts as NOT gate for the other input. So, as you can see here, for first case, A equal to 0, B equal to 0. A equal to 0 disables NAND gate number 1, causes X to become 1. Whereas, B equal to 0 also causes NAND gate number 2 to also become disabled, and output is equal to 1, irrespective what is the second input. And that's the whole property of NAND gate. When one of the input is 0, output is 1 always. Again, X equal to 1, Y equal to 1 is illogically correct. Or it is logically incorrect output, and therefore we try to avoid this case. If you remember, in the last video we have seen NOR latch, where we used to get the similar condition when A equal to 1 and B equal to 1. Here at a very starting case only, that is A equal to 0 and B equal to 0, we got the situation. So we try to avoid this case. Try to avoid this case means never ever apply A equal to 0, B equal to 0 for such type of NAND latch. Let's move to the next case when A equal to 0 and B equal to 1. Here A equal to 0 causes NAND gate number 1. See, A equal to 0 and B equal to 1. So, when one of the input is fixed to 0, output is always 1. So, it causes X to become 1. And B equal to 1 makes NAND gate number 2 acting as if it is a NOT gate for the other input, and as you can see, the other input is X. Therefore, I can say that Y is equal to what? X complement. So, when X equal to 1, Y equal to X bar, I can say X equal to 1 and Y equal to 1 complement. So, X equal to 1 and Y equal to 0. So, that's the whole conclusion. A equal to 0, B equal to 1 causes X to become 1 and Y to become 0. This is about case 2. Let's move to case 3. So, in case 3, A equal to 1, B equal to 0. So, A equal to 1 causes NAND gate number 1 to become a NOT gate for the other input. So, as you can see, the other input is Y here. The other input for NAND gate number 2 is X here. So, A equal to 1 makes X equal to Y complement, because when one of the input is fixed to 1, it becomes a NOT gate for the other input. Whereas, when one of the input is fixed to 0, output is by default 1 irrespective what was the other input, right? In fact, I said that when one of the input is equal to 0 for NAND gate, it disables the NAND gate and therefore output of the NAND gate becomes 1, irrespective what you have applied on the second input. So x equal to y bar, y equal to 1, can I say x equal to 1 bar, that is y value I have substituted and y equal to 1. So in a way x equal to 0 and y equal to 1 is a conclusion part. Meaning that when a equal to 1 and b equal to 0, x is always 0, y is always 1. Let's move to the fourth case now, a equal to 1, b equal to 1. So we know for every input when it is fixed to 1, it acts as NOT gate. Therefore, a equal to 1, see a equal to 1 and b equal to 1. So can I say that x is complement of y? So I can say x equal to y bar. And as you can see, when b is equal to 1, output y will be complement of x. So I can say that x equal to, now the value of y is x bar, so I can substitute in place of y. So I can say that it is x bar again whole bar, and y equal to x bar, but what is x? X equal to y bar, so instead of x I am writing y bar, and again we had a complement, double complement cancel each other, therefore x remains x and y remains y. I am sure you remember this case. This case is what we called as no change condition. What is meant by no change condition? For example, if x was 0 and y was 1, then it is going to remain 0, 1 and it is not going to change if a equal to 1, b equal to 1. Similarly, let's say if x was 1 and y was 0, then it remains 1, 0. It is not going to change under condition a equal to 1, b equal to 1. And therefore, this is also called as a latch condition. Is that right? So, let's summarize all the cases together. Now remember, a will be replaced with r, b will be replaced with s, x is replaced with q and y is replaced with q naught. Therefore, again we have rs 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 combination for which I am getting q and q bar, and here I am going to comment also. So let's see, for first combination, when r equal to 0, s equal to 0, you have seen q and q bar by default becomes 1 and we avoid the case. Is that right? When it is 0 1 situation, q was 1, q bar is 0. So we again consider q as main output. And depending upon the status of main output, we comment on the status of the latch. That is, if main output is 1, we say that it is in set condition, and if main output is 0, we say that it is in reset condition. So here, since q is equal to 1, we are going to say that it is in set condition. For 1-0 combination, that is in case number 3, we have already seen q was 0, q bar was 1. Again, see the main status. Main status, that is main output status, is equal to 0. Therefore, we say that the latch is in reset state. And again, for 1-1 combination, we have seen that q remains q and q bar remains q bar. And this is what we called as no change condition, or also called as a latch condition. So I'll give you a trick to remember this table. It is very simple. See, RS latch stands for, R stands for reset, and what S stands for? Set. You have to see which input is equal to 1. For example, in R and S, if R is equal to 1, then S has to be 0. When R equal to 1 and S has to be 0, in that case, you have to ask yourself which input is 1. The answer is R input is 1. And what R stands for? It stands for reset. Therefore, output should be in reset state only. You can verify for R equal to 1, S equal to 0. As you can see, it is a reset state. Also, when R equal to 0, S equal to 1, ask yourself which input is 1. It is S equal to 1. And what S stands for? Set. So, output condition of the latch will be in set condition. So, you can verify from the second case also. For 0-1 combination, you always get a set condition. And rest 0-0 and 1-1 combination, you will have to remember 0-0 stands for avoid this condition because outputs are logically incorrect. As well as for 1-1 condition, it is no change condition. That is, it is acting as a latch operation. So, I am sure you have understood this NAND latch. NAND latch is very, very important from gate point of view. In fact, on practical grounds, I want to tell you that NAND gate has a propagation delay which is quite lesser as compared to NOR latch or as compared to NOR gate. That's the reason why NAND gates are practically faster as compared to NOR gates. That's the reason why in every flip-flop or in every latch circuit you must have seen, they never use a NOR gate. They always construct the circuit with the help of NAND gate, and that's the reason behind it. So in future, I'm going to use only NAND gate in order to have SR latch or JK latch or T latch and so on. Thank you.